गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी, प्लीज वेट फॉर सम टाइम, वी विल शॉर्टली स्टार्ट द मीटिंग. वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग सम मोर पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू ज्वाइन. सो हम लोग 5 मिनट के अंदर मीटिंग फिर से शुरू करेंगे, तो प्लीज वेट कीजिए जरा. Very good evening. My name is Sunil. Am I audible?
Yes, Sunil, you can carry on. You are audible.
Yeah, thank you, sir. आप सबों का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद इतने शॉर्ट नोटिस पे ये मीटिंग ज्वाइन करने के लिए. आई थिंक हिंदी में बात करना ज्यादा उचित रहेगा या फिर वी कैन डिस्कस इन इंग्लिश एज पर योर कन्वीनियंस. सो थैंक यू सो मच वंस अगेन एंड ज्वाइनिंग अस ऑन अ वेरी शॉर्ट नोटिस. वी वेलकम यू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स फ्रॉम आवर एमएसएमई फ्रेटर्निटी. And we have created this platform and this meeting to discuss something that is of immense importance for everybody, specifically talking about MSME in India, operational under food processing industry. So before moving ahead, I would like to introduce Mr. Faraj Faridi, who is our general manager, and we have other team members also from FIPSI who have joined this meeting. So I would request Mr. Faraj to give you an introductory note and start the meeting. Faraj sir, please.
Good evening, everyone.
आप लोग अपना माइक म्यूट पे रखेंगे तो ज्यादा बेटर रहेगा. या फराज सर प्लीज.
Can I have the PPT, please?
Just a second.
First of all, a hearty welcome to all who are there. This is a very short notice that we had given for a webinar, and we are thankful to everyone, as Sunil has said. Firstly, I'd like to give you a small input as to what PIXIE, that is Food Industry Capacity and Skill Initiative, is all about. We are a sector skill council for food processing. Sunil, can I have the second slide? The agenda of the meeting is about PIXIE skilling opportunities that have been created in the last number of years, employment ecosystem that is there present in the food processing industry memberships that we envisage that industry will partner us in training the local workforce in and around the area the industry is formed. And we expect the industry to come forward and let us know as to what kind or what expertise are required for the industry with their workforce, so that when they employ them, then they're already trained to take up the work that is being done in the industry. There's some technical session, and we'll have an open forum after that, question answer on anything that any inquiries or any questions the industry members who are present, they want to do or have with us. First of all, as you all know, PIXIE is widely known as a sector skill council for food processing, and is not a for-profit organization floated by FICCI, that is Federation of Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, with the help of the skill ministry, that is MSDE and NSDC. And we are very ably and strongly supported by the ministry, by MOFPI, that is Ministry of Food Processing Industries. So both these ministries are strongly supporting us on our endeavor to train the workforce in and around where the food industry are located, or and the food parks around in India that the Ministry of Food Processing has been putting up along with the private partners. And we have the third slide. Our major function is, first of all, we develop standards. The standards are curriculums or contents and how the assessments will take place. So this is all done in collaboration with the industry to a large extent, and validated by the industry. And then we take it up to the ministry and through NSDC, where NSDA and the required authorities give permission whether this course can be floated on an NSQF aligned course. Then we have we do assessments and TOT. Assessors are trained by us. The trainers are trained by us. The trainers are aligned to certain training partners. We don't do training directly, but their training is done to our training partners who have trainers, and those trainers are supposed to have certain qualifications that are given on our website, and they go a certain level of training with us, similarly with the assessment assessors, so that a certain level of standard is maintained of whatever skills that are being imparted. Then we participation in setting up of affiliation and accreditation, that is accreditation of training centers. So there are certain norms that have to be followed by the training centers, and most of them are generally affiliated to the NSDC or to the state missions or PIXIE, that is. We work closely with policymakers to policymakers are generally everybody in the food processing industry, coming from the industry up to the level of the government authorities who actually give the go ahead for NSGC, NSQS aligned courses. Next slide. Sunil, can I? We have some major industry partners with us. So they are Nestle, Britannia, Cremica, Tetra Pak, ITC, Cargill, Mother's Recipe, Haldiram, MTR, LT Foods, Patanjali, and Godrej Agrovet, to name a few. We have many more. And we will like most of the food processing industries to be in touch with us and give us the demand as to what number of employees they propose to employ in the coming years, and what is the expertise that is required them by them. If it is not there in the curriculums or job roles that are put up at the NSQF level, then they can collaborate with us and ask us to make courses that are required with the with that particular industry. Next. We have a few knowledge partners who help us to design the program. You are very good with us. We have signed the MOU with FSSAI. FSSAI has empaneled us, and with us they have collaborated to in the first year, that that is 2021, they have envisaged that we will be training at least around about 5 lakh candidates and under FSSAI courses, which is a big boost for the industry that is aligned with us. And this is one of the major factors that we are seeing a lot of input coming in from the industry, and the industry taking up FICCI membership and aligning with us. FICCI has collaboration with premier educational institutes. They are NIFTIM, that is a National Institute for Food food Training, and that is at Khondli. It comes under the Ministry of Food Processing. Similarly, we have IIFPT, that is in Thanjavur. We have collaboration with CFTRI that does a lot of research in food processing. We have MOU with IGNU, which is spread out. Basically, we are required to go to every nook and corner of the country. So IGNU is one university all over India that has the mandate to train or skill or educate people all over India, and they can give courses. So we have aligned with IGNU. And in Delhi, we are aligned with Lady Irwin College, which is one of the renowned colleges in food processing, and they are doing a good job there. MOU, we have signed recently with MOU with Food Processing Skills Canada. Now, we are going to have a lot of input from Canada, wherein we will bring in international standards. Apart from that, we envisage that the MSME industry in India will try and collaborate with people in Canada, or have a dialogue with them through the Food Processing Skills Canada, which we can facilitate, and we will offer you these services later on. Yes, Sunil, next.
Yeah. Thank you, Faraj sir. Bahut bahut dhanyawad aapka.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity. And please, can you take us through the rest of the thing, and then we can have a one-on-one interaction with the candidates who are here.
Right. Thank you, sir. So, main Hindi mein bolunga, aap log ko koi pareshani na ho to, because I would try to speak in Hindi and English both. So, hum log zyada interact kar sakein. फराज सर ने जैसा बताया कि हमारी जो संस्था है इंडिया में एक एपेक्स बॉडी है जो फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री में स्किल डेवलपमेंट और कैपेसिटी डेवलपमेंट का काम करती है। और जहाँ तक भारत का सवाल है, एमएसएमई जो समाज है हमारा, एमएसएमई जो ग्रुप है हमारा, वो किसी भी सेक्टर में डेवलपमेंट का फोकस रहा है और आगे भी ये फोकस रहेगा। अगर हम फूड प्रोसेसिंग की बात करें तो फूड प्रोसेसिंग सेक्टर अभी जितना अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड है उतना भी ऑर्गेनाइज नहीं हुआ है। सो हमारे पास ऑर्गेनाइज्ड प्लेयर काफी कम है, अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड प्लेयर काफी सारे हैं जो इस इंडस्ट्री में काम कर रहे हैं। So, basic agenda of this meeting to connect with our MSME fraternity and discuss about our collaboration, because we are creating an ecosystem where skilling and capacity development would be in full phase with the support of our MSME fraternity. I will take you through this slide first, and then we can discuss one-on-one what kind of benefits we can take, what kind of future that we see through our collaboration as a community in food processing industry. So discussed by Mr. Faraj, we have signed MOU with Food Processing Skills Canada. This is Sector Skill Council in Canada, which takes care of skilling and capacity development in food processing industry in Canada. And it is a very prestigious moment for us that we are sharing that this Sector Skill Council has signed an MOU with us, where we would be having technology transfer from Canada, whatever technology that they are using in Canadian context in food processing industry, that would be discussed and that would be transferred to Indian food processing industry need based. If the need would be there, you would be having a step or a process to transfer the technology from Canada to India. We would be connecting our Indian MSME fraternity with Canadian MSME fraternity working in the food processing industry. We would also have various seminars with Canadian food industry experts to facilitate you gaining understanding and knowledge about what new is happening in their industry, what technology had been brought, what can be adopted in Indian context, how we can leverage that and how we can promote that. Because if you see, this MOU is important in a way that 2.4 million people in Canada are Indians. So there is a huge diaspora of Indians in Canada, and we have a huge potential for our products and services, specifically in food processing industry in Canada. Why we're talking skill, why there is a thrust on skill development? Government has been talking about skill development every here and there, and see there is a need of skill development. What is the importance? Why we're talking about skill development? So there is a saying, if you invest in technology, you invest in machinery, maybe your production would be increased by 10% or 20%. But if you invest in your human capital, if you invest in your people, the productivity could be increased to many folds. So here we are talking about skilling your employees, skilling your people who are supporting your organization grow, because those are the building blocks of a company, those are the face of the organization. And your success majorly depends upon what kind of skill set that they have, what kind of mindset that they have, and what is the vision and mission alignment with your organizational vision and mission of your employees. So we will talk about various skilling initiatives that we have been taking, and we would be proposing with you to take that. Apart from that, if you see, talking about skill development, you would be having increased employee satisfaction, because employee would be satisfied that now company is thinking about that particular person. So you would be dedicated, you would be more loyal to your company. You'd be having skills to perform the tasks and duties that you are giving to you. You would be having retention rate, higher retention rate of the employees, because employee would not be leaving your company as they understand that the company is investing so much of money in their particular skill development, their progress of career progression and all. They would also having a development in employee engagement. If an employee is satisfied, he would be more prone, more keen to understand your knowledge and processes. And he would be giving it 100% towards the achievement of the goals of your organization. They would be also supporting you in connecting with clients, because your marketing team is not the only team which has the connect with your clients. Your employees could also get connects through employers. As they are loyal to your company, they would be definitely bringing more customers and talking about sales and support services of your organization with the customers. There would be improvement in the communication system of your organization, because every employee would be skilled and understanding the exact process, how they are going to perform the task and how they are going to maintain a feedback and a communication channel in the organization. And overall, if you'll see the return on investment on training employees would be great as a culture development, as a organizational development, because in any way you are spending so much money on your employees, like salary, EPF, like other benefits. And if you're not spending that little bit that is required for skill development, that you are ruining the whole investment. So investment in terms of human capital development is very, very important, and it is very, very required for the development of overall culture and overall organization. So we'll talk about some skilling initiative that we have undertaken, and we would look forward to you to join us and to see how you can take the benefit of this skilling initiative. We have launched our online learning management system, where we have put various courses which are free of cost so far. You can join our learning management system, you can log in there, and you can have free access to these courses. Like, we have created courses on safe practices for retail food handlers and safe practices for MSME during and post COVID. These courses could be undergone by anybody who is interested. He just need to go to our LMS and he could log in there. And after login, you can go through these courses. These are absolutely free. Please join our LMS, go through these courses. And after these courses, you would be getting a certification from FSSAI on COVID. So this is, we know we are hit with a pandemic which is global. And if you come to know about do's and don'ts of this particular scenario, you would be better equipped to fight this pandemic right now and in future also. So I request you to please go to our LMS, read these courses and get certified. This is free of cost. Apart from that, we have been creating different modules on qualification packs that we have developed. So far, we have developed 49 qualification packs, which is related to food processing industry. And these courses would be digitized and be available on the LMS. So that if you want to learn anything, if you want to nominate your employees to learn those courses, they can go through the LMS and they could be learning these courses. These courses would be paid later on. The courses that I talked about on safe practices for COVID, these are free so far. The other courses which would be available on LMS would be paid courses. We have a provision to create customized courses also for our MSME fraternity. If you wish to create a course based on your requirement for your employees, you can create that online and you can take access of that course, and then your employees can go through that. After going through that course, the employees could be assessed and certified. I will share the details of login and links at the end of the slide, and we would also share this PPT with you over mail. Apart from this, there is a good opportunity in terms of National Apprenticeship Promotion Scheme, that's NAPS. And it talks about, the NAPS is one of the most efficient way to develop skilled manpower by using training facilities available in your establishment. So whatever facility that you have, you can train these candidates in that particular premises. Apprentices with a band of 2.5% of the workforce are mandatory. It is mandatory that minimum limit of 2.5% of the total manpower strength should be kept as apprentice in the organization. And this is not only the case if you are talking about keeping these candidates or any person as an apprentice. There is a subsidy of 25% and up to 1500 rupees per apprentice per month to these apprentices. So you'd be getting, you don't have to pay anything. Anyway, they are trainees to your company. After that, also government is providing subsidy. This is a win-win situation for you. You can participate in this program. The link to this particular website is given here. That is apprenticeshipindia.org. You can go there and you can follow the rules and regulations and register your company, and you can get benefit out of this scheme. There are a lot of benefits that this particular scheme provides you, like it would be enhancing the morale of the staff, it would be improving productivity, reducing staff turnover, attract the best candidates that you want to deploy in your organization, increase your diversity, create talent pipeline for your organization, skilling existing staffs also, improve your company image, and overall match the skills of employee to the skills you need. Right now, if we talk about foreign country and any other country where there is a small unit, they are working so professionally that they have excelled in their field. In the context of India, if you'll see, if you are a very small unit, you don't be professional enough to have those candidates who are running the business professionally. No, if you want to run your business professionally, if you want to grow to a height that you have seen, you need to have professional staff in the company. And those professional staff could be supporting your company or yourself to reach that limit that you have set. So everything, whether it's a small organization or it's a mid-sized organization, they need to be managed professionally. For management, professional management, you need professional employees. There is a scheme from Government of India, Sampada scheme, which is a scheme for human resource institutional skill development, which is under Ministry of Food Processing and Entrepreneurship. This scheme gives opportunity to you to set up training centers to train candidates. And not only that, it would be giving you grant in ads at the rate of 50% of the tools and equipment cost. So suppose if you're planning to open a skilling center for dairy processing and the cost is 22 lakhs, you'd be getting 10 lakhs straight away as a grant from the Government of India. So it's not only about scaling, it's about creating a business model out of this particular opportunity. As an entrepreneur, you can take this advantage and create a model where you skill those candidates also, and you create a model by which you would be selling those products which are being made and prepared during the practical in that particular setup. So it's a complete business model. It's not only about scaling system where you are enrolling candidates and doing scaling. It's a complete model. You just need to exploit these opportunity and resources that are being provided to government. It would be a win-win situation for you also, for participants also as joining as a trainee, and for overall scaling ecosystem as well. In continuation to the initiative that we have taken in terms of scaling and learning, there is a felt need to propose this training program on FASTAC, that is Food Safety Supervising Training. It is mandated by FSSAI, and I hope you all would be knowing that we need to have FASTAC supervisors certified from FSSAI and FASTAC in your organization if you are working in the food processing industry. So far we have undertaken more than 30,000 trainings in this particular domain. And as Faraj sir told, that FSSAI had given a letter to train more than 5 lakh candidates in 2021. This initiative is a big step that we have taken, and we are connecting with different channel partners, MSMEs and corporates to promote this training program. And you can take the benefit of this training program from this platform as well. So we have experienced and certified trainers who would be delivering these training programs. We have planned to deliver all the three types of courses like basic, advanced and special courses. The complete training would be online, so you don't need to go anywhere. You can undergo the training by having just a mobile phone or a tablet or a laptop at your home, and you would be undergoing the training program. The assessment would be happening online, and after that you can get the certification online. So complete online system, there is no physical ways or physical delivery or physical training. There would be dual certification which would be provided after completing this course. Usually you get fast track certification for food safety supervisor, but if you undertake this training program from our end, we would be providing a certificate of participation from FICCI also. That would have a different image, that would have a different value addition to your collection certification and your program. So the pricing that we have kept are nominal as compared to other training programs. So basic courses are charged at 800 rupees, advanced are 1100 rupees, and special courses are charged at 1500 rupees. These charges are all inclusive GST. So you do not need to pay anything more apart from this. Now we talk about employment ecosystem in India. Food processing industry, there were no such portal or a platform where exchange of employment could happen in India so far. FICCI has launched its first food job portal in food processing industry that is exclusively for food processing industry. So we are talking about students from premium colleges like NIFTM, IFT, Lady Irwin and other colleges on a year basis, where courses are going on under food processing. We are connecting with colleges to upload the database of their candidates so that you could log in the job portal and you can choose candidates from the pool of these candidates who are technically qualified from good institutions. You can take them as an employee, you can take them as an intern, whatever, but you can get good database on this particular platform. I will discuss about subscription and other things to this particular job portal in my later slide, because we have created a bouquet of services to our subscribers who could get benefit of the job portal also. The details of linkage and links and website would be provided in the end of the PPT, and we will share that PPT also with you. Apart from this, we have a network of more than 300 VWOC colleges. VWOC colleges in food processing industry on pan-India basis. So these colleges send their candidates on a internship for 1 month or 2 months, depending upon the state and the requirement of the college. So you can get benefited by taking these students as interns in their company. You can get your work done. In return, they would be learning few things from your organization and they would be completing their internship. So there is a good opportunity for you to take interns from VWO colleges who are trained and qualified in food processing industry in the different job roles. Now we have created a platform where you can become our member, where you can connect with FICCI. You could become the part of the ecosystem, and these are the benefits that we are providing to you after becoming members. So we would be providing 3 fast track trainings per year to your employees. We would be having seminars with experts from India and Canadian industry quarterly. So in one quarter, we would be having one seminar either from Indian industry expert or Canadian industry expert. We would be giving you access to our job portal with 5 job postings. After that, if you want to post more jobs, you can definitely go for buying a subscription pack. There would be annual interaction with senior government officials or industry members as per the availability and need, what is felt by you people and our connection with them. We would be having access to our newsletter, which we publish from FICCI that contains all the details and all the news that is happening in the Indian skilling ecosystem and food processing industry in India. There would be annual interaction with FSSAI members, which would be planned with you. You can connect with them. You can join a webinar or a meeting. You can discuss your issues and problems with them, and you can get that resolved. You can get your queries resolved. So that would be with the FSSAI member. We would be also connecting need-based customized technical trainings. So if you are, let's say, working in a dairy or processing industry and you want specific trainings to be provided to your employees in a particular location, we can create the module. Though already we have already created these modules, you can request us, we can provide a trainer who could go there and train your candidates or employees, and they can get benefited out of the particular training. So the membership fee that we have kept for eligible members is at 3,000 rupees per annum plus GST. But if you are availing this service right now till 30th of September, you would be getting this membership fee at 2,000 rupees plus GST. So this is for early birds. So become an early bird and, you know, join us so that you could get benefited out of this scheme also. There would be different technical sessions that we would be planning with our MSME fraternity, where we would be talking about online webinars and meetings with industry experts that I already spoke. There would be need-based session on specific subjects. So suppose our group of MSMEs are suggesting that we need to have a session on this particular topic. We would be identifying the concerned person, the person concerned authority, either in government segment or industry. We can align a webinar or a meeting on that particular subject, and we can all get benefited out of that. We would be connecting with our knowledge partners like, you know, NIFTEM, CFTRI, IFT, Lady Irwin, and you would be getting opportunity to interact with them if you have any kind of suggestion that you seek from them, because they are already our knowledge associates. They would be happy to help you. And obviously, session from Food Processing Skill Canada. It's a huge advantage that we have received from Canadian, you know, Sector Skill Council. And it is the future where we would be getting a lot of technology exchange, a lot of information exchange from that. So stay tuned. We would be facilitating a lot of sessions with our MSME and their MSMEs, and would be getting knowledge and technology transfer from Canada to India. Now to open this forum and request you all to come up with any question, any suggestion if you have. You can see these links. You can connect with Mr. Harsh at the email ID that is given and the mobile number that is provided here. You can also visit our websites. Website is www.ficsi.in. We have the job portal, which is at portal.ficsi.in. LMS portal. These links would be provided to you. I would request my colleagues to share this PPT with all the participants, and you can go through these. You can take the benefit and you can align with us. Apart from this, these are the social media where we, you know, keep posting our new things, what is happening in the market, what are the new technologies we are talking about in food processing industry, what's new is going on. So you can follow us and like us on these social media platforms like LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. So we would be sharing this links with you. Now I would open the group forum, and if you have any kind of suggestion, any question, we can discuss about that. Mr. Faraj is there with us. So please, platform is yours. Please, any question, any suggestion. Seeking your participation, your support, and with the support of each other only would be going big. The potential is very huge. Let's see how we can leverage that. and we would definitely seek your association with us. So please open up and say if you have any concern, any suggestion, any query, we would be happy to support you on that. Raj sir, you want to add something?
Can you go back some slides where we are talking about maps and this?
Yeah.
See, there is a lot of advantage that can be taken by MSMEs on NAPS or apprenticeship schemes that of Government of India that have come in. Not listed here are some hidden aspects that are not considered. The trainees or people who you employ as trainees are working for you normally. And in that period of time, they are being trained. You are incurring the full cost of training them for 6 months or 3 months or 9 months, whatever the period is. But if they are listed as trainees and they are under NAPS, then you are getting not only getting rupees 1500 per month, that is subsidizing the cost of the industry, but also as trainee, they are not under NAPS, they are not liable to be, they are not employees of the organization. So you don't need to pay, register them under EPF or PF, ESI. All this is not, these are not, they are not entitled to this. So while the training period is going on, if you register them under NAPS, there are certain other advantages also, and they have to undergo a test or assessment at after they complete 3 months or at different stages. What happens is once you train them, they are certified. Now, even if you don't employ them, they have that certification. They can be employed by a different firm or industry nearby or wherever they apply. And they can tell that industry that, yes, I have undergone this training. And so the candidate is also not losing, and you have a choice whether to employ all five of them that you had taken in as trainers or four of them. And you can choose two or three of them, and the rest you can, they can go and apply in some other firm. They don't have to undergo the full training again, which is an added advantage. So this is one thing that is there in NAPS, and there are many more advantages that once you discuss in particular with us, we will let you know. Can we go to the SHRISD scheme of MOFP? Mr. Sunil? See, under the MOFP scheme, this is a scheme that envisages that anybody who's opening up a training center, now, who all are entitled to opening up a training center. They are people who are aligned with the State Skill Mission, NSDC, or FICCI. Apart from that, if an industry wants to open up a training center in its own premises or adjacent to it, they can also apply. They are entitled to it. And for this, for the equipment that is going to be installed in that place, 50% of the equipment cost as per the job role is given to them, maximum of 15 lakhs per job role. So each center can have up to five different job roles. And this is a grant in aid, which is a one-time grant in aid given by the food processing ministry. So this doesn't have to be returned. It is only there to for you to set up that training center, and the guarantee they take is that you will be doing training in food processing for the food processing industry, at least 50 or 100 candidates in a year. So even if you want to have a training center adjacent to your place, you can start a business like that, or you can start it for your, depending how big the firm is. These two are offers that are there from the Government of India through the Skill Ministry and through Food Ministry, which our industry can take up. Can we proceed to the next, Sunil? COSTAC is another facility that is being offered by FICCI, and we have this course on online. We are giving it online. So a lot of our members, our training partners, are already taking advantage of this. And we feel, because in the next couple of years, FSSAI is spreading its wing, and it's coming up with the laws are already there in place that the industry should have people who are FSSAI certified. So this is the right time to start building your base and start your candidates or employees or lower level employees to get this advantage. So I think we should, we have come to the end. I'll like each and every one of you. I think if you have any questions, you can take it up here or you can write to us. We will definitely get back to you. You can, anybody who is becoming a member will hear from us. We will send mails to each one of you, and we look forward to having you as our partners, as our members for years to come to take forward the food processing industry.
And you can also send mails, the mail ID that has been shared with you. We'll share the PPT, you will get the email ID and the details also. And we look forward to hear from you. Let's collaborate and make this a big success, because there is a lot of opportunity in food processing industry. I would request all of you to kindly switch on your camera. There is a gesture that we have started being in practice, that we take snaps of our participants and we keep that posted on the social media and other places. So I would request you to kindly switch on the camera, please. So we are not seeing and meeting everybody physically. So let's make a good face so that we capture good a picture at least. So that everybody knows that on the web also we are having good connect and good moments together. Please, Mr. Prakash Vyas, can you please open your camera? Chandan ji, Sagar ji, Mausmi, please open your camera. Yeah, taken. So we are taking the snaps. Huh? Just a second, please. Yeah, the people are getting inspired. Please, please open up your camera, please. You're done coming? Done? Yeah, thank you so much. And I look forward. Yeah, please. If
thank you so much, sir.
Still have any question, any query, please send
us the mail. Thank you very much. I think this was the first or second interaction we are having with the industry. You will see much more of us on the field, in your locality, and in seminars and other get-togethers that we have. I think we need to take the food industry forward.
Ravi ji, you are telling something.
Yeah, this is Ravi Kumar.
Yeah,
I'm principal of Khadi Gramodyog Mahavidyalaya, Skill Development Training Center of Khadi and Village. Industries Commission and Board.
Yeah.
Am I getting you? Am I audible you?
Yeah, you're audible, please.
So this is Ravi Kumar Nimaluri, Principal of Skill Development Training College of KVIC and KVIB. It is being jointly operated by KVIC and KVIB. Yes. Our training center is situated at Rajendra Nagar, Hyderabad. So this is very, good, useful program for us. I'll definitely keep in contact with you. Together we can, organize some training programs. And Asterji, do you provide any assistance for us for providing this food-based training institutes? I mean, for setting up of some machinery and because we have got some good potential over here.
Mr. Ravi, we already said that, we are connected with two ministries. Our line ministry is the Ministry for Food Processing, which is already giving a grant in aid up to the tune of 15 lakhs per job role. So any course that you take up, which is aligned by through NSQF, they and you are affiliated with FICCI, they will give you to a maximum of 15 lakhs per job role. You get per center. If you in one center, you can take up 5 job roles. That means you can go in for 75 lakhs of aid, grant in aid, depending on which job roles you choose. So some job roles. The equipment is given on our website, the cost of which can be shared with you once you identify the job roles that you want to take. So the lab equipment will all be shared 50-50 with the food ministry. That is one of the schemes that has been brought into focus by the line ministry for increasing the ground presence of our training centers. So that we can share with you. And once you have a training center which is running and definitely which has the input by the government, I feel the local skill mission and the central skill mission and the sector skill council have a focus to give you numbers wherever they can or help you out to get numbers and run your courses. Apart from whatever courses or whatever number of candidates you can get as paid courses. So we are definitely backing you on that. So if you align with us, there are a lot of schemes that we can suggest and a lot of schemes keep coming up of the state governments also, which we can align with you.
So I'll definitely be in touch with you, sir. Thank you very much.
I'll request everybody to get in touch with us if they require anything, any information regarding starting a skill center is required. Thank you very much.
So thank you so much once again for joining us, and we look forward to connect with you. Let's take this forward. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you very much for everybody who's been here. We are glad to have you on our webinar, and we will be happy to have you as members of the food processing faculty. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you.